In my last video, I showed you how DDS is used in many function generators to synthesize signals. Here I have 33250A from Agilent. This instrument uses DDS, and here I have a 33522A, which has true point-by-point arbitrary waveform generation capabilities. In this video, I'll show you how you can use the 33522A to overcome some of the disadvantages from DDS waveform generator. So here I have the same arbitrary waveform being output by two different function generators. On the top in yellow is a DDS generator, and in green is the Agilent 33522A. And so the arbitrary waveform is basically a sine wave with this little glitch. And what we're going to do is see what happens to this glitch on each generator as we increase the frequency. This is the glitch on the DDS generator. And as we increase the frequency of the arbitrary waveform, DDS is skipping some of the points in waveform memory. And you can see the waveform become more and more distorted the higher the frequency gets. This is the glitch from the 33522A. As you can see, when we change the frequency, the waveform amplitude and shape stays the same. This is because the 33522 uses true point-by-point arbitrary waveform generation. This means that all the samples in waveform memory are output exactly once, and you don't end up with aliasing like you do in DDS from skipping samples. Thank you.